In this video, we will de novo assemble some NGS data. The reads have already been trimmed, so to begin, select the paired trimmed reads list, then in the toolbar, click the Align Assemble button and choose De Novo Assembly. This will open the De Novo Assembler Settings window. The Geneious De Novo Assembler parses your input data and will select the appropriate sensitivity setting to use. In most cases, you will not need to adjust the sensitivity setting. The assembler also estimates the amount of memory required to perform the assembly, and will warn you if it believes you will not have enough RAM to assemble your data. The sensitivity setting adjusts various advanced options. If you wish to see how these advanced settings change depending on sensitivity, click on the More Options button in the bottom left corner of the settings window. Then change the sensitivity setting and watch how the advanced options change. Hover over each advanced setting to see a description. If you wish to modify specific advanced settings, then set sensitivity to custom sensitivity. In this example, we will use the default settings. To reset to the default settings, click on the gear icon in the bottom left corner of the window and choose Reset to Defaults. In the results section of the window, check the options to 1. Save an assembly report, 2. Save contigs, and 3. Save consensus sequences. The trim setting of the settings window is primarily for Sanger sequences, so set this to Do Not Trim. Click OK to start the assembly. Upon completion of the assembly, three new files will be created: an assembly report, an assembly file, and a consensus sequence generated from the assembly. Select the assembly report to view it. In this example, all of the reads should assemble as a single contig, so the report will be simple. For more complex assemblies resulting in multiple contigs, various statistics, including N50, will be reported. The assembly report provides a Show Options link that opens the assembly settings window. This shows you the assembler options used during assembly. Now open the contig file. By default, assembled paired reads will be colored according to their assembled paired distance. The color will depend on how the paired distance differs from the expected distance that was set. Select the General tab in the side panel and click on the Options link to see the color scheme. Use the zoom controls to zoom in and see the sequences at the nucleotide level. Click on the Statistics tab to see the mean coverage for the assembly file. Click on the Graphs tab to see the settings that can be adjusted for the blue coverage graph. These settings allow you to identify areas of high or low or single-stranded coverage. Click on the Insert Sizes tab to see a histogram showing the distribution of calculated insert sizes based on the assembly of the paired reads. In this example, we can see that the mean paired distance is very close to the predicted expected insert size of 350 base pairs. De novo assembly of large data sets requires significant RAM and computational time. We will now normalize our trimmed paired read list and assemble again. Select the trimmed paired list and go to Sequence and Error Correct and Normalize Reads. Use the default settings, but uncheck the option for error correction. Click OK to run. When completed, the tool will create a new normalized list. If we select the normalized list, you can see it contains 3,776 reads. This is close to a 50% reduction compared to our original list of 7,800 reads. Now, when we repeat de novo assembly, the assembly of the normalized dataset takes around one-third of the time compared to the full read dataset. If you select the normalized contig and view the statistics tab, you'll see this contig has an average coverage of 52.3. Normalization can significantly reduce the time required for assembly, with no loss in accuracy of the assembly. For this example, we use the Geneious De Novo assembly algorithm. A number of other algorithms are available in Geneious. Several are bundled with Geneious and others are available as plugins. See the Knowledge Base article for a brief summary of the various assemblers.